Hello everyone, thank you so much for subscribing my channel Mahesh English Times. I hope you're liking my videos which are based on English language, literature and English research. I have done this many videos on related to research, those who are doing research specifically on English literature. This particular video is devoted to those scholars who are about to start their journey as PhD scholars of English literature and how to choose the topic. This is a very gripping question which comes in front of them, that how to choose a topic, on which particular topic should they undergo the PhD thesis. So let's see how to choose the topic of PhD thesis. So let's see how can we search the topic for PhD in English literature. Now English literature nowadays, the theses are written, they are coming under two categories. The theses which are written in purely English literature, those theses which are written purely based on literature. And there are theses which are interdisciplinary. Interdisciplinary in the sense that they are not actually belonging to English literature, but they are diverging into fields of political science, sociology, history, and they are taking certain elements of those subjects and, you know, integrating it with English literature. So those theses are actually called as PhD thesis in English, not exactly in English literature. So there are two kinds of thesis that are being written and that are being done by PhD scholars. The interdisciplinary which I am talking about is, as I already mentioned, that they are subjects related to psychology, sociology, history, political science. They are diverging into those fields. They are doing survey based thesis, that, you know, what is the psychological, suppose you are doing a psychological aspects covered in a particular novel of any writer or novels of the writer. So that means you are going into the field of psychology. If you are covering sociological aspects or historical aspects covered by any writer in his novels or poems, so definitely we are diverging towards history, towards these subjects, and we have to incorporate elements of these subjects into our thesis of English literature. It will not be completely purely of English literature. Now interdisciplinary research which has been conducted nowadays is also survey based, which is called as quantitative research, in which you collect the data, you do data analysis and then statistical analysis, and there are certain software available to analyze your data. And this kind of data analysis and sample collection is usually done in thesis of sociology, in the thesis of history, and not basically done in the thesis of purely English literature. But nowadays students are doing it interdisciplinary. They are collecting the data, they are doing the analysis and making it a part of thesis of English literature. Now we will see how sample based thesis, what are the examples of sample based thesis, or where data collection is required, what are those examples that is actually included in thesis of English literature. Now there are problems which are faced by students to learn English. So suppose you do a survey of two colleges or three colleges, and where you ask them questions that what are the problems that students are facing while learning English. So you collect that data, collect the answers, do the analysis. It will be called a thesis of English, but it is basically you're doing the survey and collecting data, which is usually done by scholars of sociology and history. So that is why. Or you're doing a survey on impact of learning communication skills on village students. So how communication skills, whether village students are able to speak confidently and communicate confidently. Again, you have to do a survey, make a questionnaire, let the students fill the questionnaire, collect the sample, do data analysis with the help of a software, and this is also coming under the thesis of English literature. Or the teaching styles which are adopted of teaching English language by teachers. Again, this is of data collection, importance of the four skills in learning of English. So these are some topics which are covered by scholars of English when they are doing thesis in English literature, but these are all interdisciplinary. They are related to data collection, sampling, which is usually done by students of humanities who are doing research in sociology or psychology, but this will be also coming under the thesis of English nowadays. Now the topics for thesis of purely, if you want to do your thesis of purely on English literature where data collection and all these aspects are not involved, now how can you get those topics, from where can you search those topics? Most important thing is the topic which you like, the writer which you like. That is something which is most important. You should go about it. But there are many other ways of coming to this concept or coming to a particular writer of English literature. So there is a website called Shodh Ganga in which theses are being uploaded. So around the world, around the globe, whatever theses are there in various streams, English, Hindi, humanities, science, engineering. So all those theses, after their submission to the particular university, they are being uploaded on this website. So you can go search for your particular stream and see which topics and which theses have been done specifically for English literature or your subject. You can go to another website which is Shodh Gangotri. Now in this, the synopsis is being uploaded, not the thesis, but synopsis of many PhD scholars is being uploaded. So you can go to and visit this website just to come to a conclusion about which particular topic you want to choose. There is an site of MHRD, you know, Ministry of Human Resource Development, and in that site, if you go, there is a section called Thrust Areas. In that also you get ideas, specifically students of science and engineering, they get ideas of on which particular topic you want to do your research. Then there are authors on which you can do, there are characters, themes, plot and style which are covered in any particular novel or poem on which you can do your thesis. You can do on autobiographies or biographies, you can do on travelogues, you can do a comparative study between two writers, writers who are writing in English or writers who are writing in Hindi and in English. So you can do a comparative study. Then translation studies are also done where the original books have been written in Tamil, Telugu or Sanskrit languages and they've been translated into English. So on those topics also you can do your thesis. The writers, if you're doing specifically a thesis of purely English literature, the writers which are less explored, on which you should do and you must go about doing your PhD thesis in English literature, is these are the names of those writers. We have Louis Gluck, who just recently won the Nobel Prize in 2020, Robert Walser, Carson McCullers, Pavickal, Everett and Linda Barry. So these are the American or British writers who have been less explored and less covered up by PhD scholars, which can be taken up by a scholar who is about to start a thesis in English literature. Now there are certain Indian writers who have also been less explored. You can take them up also for your thesis. This will be purely thesis of English literature. Jeet Thayali, Amit Chaudhary, Sudha Murthy, Amish Tripathi, Shashi Tharoor, Aga Shahid Ali and Devdutt Patnaik. So these are writers who are not much explored, although they are also being explored nowadays by scholars, but still you can go about and, you know, take up a new concept or new idea of their books, the theme covered in their books, and something new you can come up with and do your thesis purely on English literature. So I hope this video is helpful for those who are searching for a topic of PhD specifically in English literature. And this will, and you can decide whether you want to do on the sample collection or interdisciplinary, or you want to do purely on English literature. So I hope this video is helpful for you. Thank you so much for watching.